Hi guys, my name is Deepak and you're welcome back to this channel. And whoever is new here, most welcome. On this channel, we publish vlogs, photo and video editing tutorials, and a lot more. So if you have interest in such content, make sure to subscribe. Video editing isn't that easy and it's a time-consuming process if you don't know how to be efficient in that. Rather than wasting time in editing, it's better if you know a way that could make your life easier and that whole video editing process less stressful. So to achieve that, I'm going to show 10 of my favorite keyboard shortcuts in this video. I bet you'll be amazed by the end of this video that how much this video could help you in your video editing process. So now, without wasting any more time, let's begin. Also, I have added time codes in the description below. So if you want to learn about any specific shortcut, you can simply click that time code. You don't need to watch the whole video, but I suggest you should. If you want to go to the first frame of the clip or the end frame of the clip, with mouse, it's not that easy. You know why? Because with mouse, you need to hold the playhead, drag it, but finding the first and last frame, it's difficult. Make your life easier by hitting just one keystroke. To go to the first frame, hit the up arrow key, and if you want to go to the end frame, hit the down arrow key. And that's it. The second shortcut is zoom in and zoom out the timeline. It's very common while editing that you need to expand or shrink the timeline. But if you do it with your mouse, you do it like this. I don't know its name, but I call it horizontal scroll bar. But if you want to save time, you can simply click plus sign to expand or zoom in the timeline and hit the minus sign to shrink or zoom out the timeline. Simple. Now, bonus tip. If you want to expand your video and audio layers, how do you do that? You hold these layers and drag up and down, right? But you can do that very easily by holding the shift and plus key to expand and shift with minus key to shrink. So easy, right? If you want to maximize any window inside Premiere Pro, you can simply do it using this key. People call it with different names, I call it acute key. So let's say if you want to maximize timeline, you simply select the timeline and hit this key. It will maximize it. Similarly, if you want to maximize program monitor, you can select the program monitor and hit this key. That's it. Another bonus tip. If you want to expand your program monitor to actual full screen, then you can do it by holding the control key on your Mac and hit the acute key. It will make it full screen. But this shortcut only works for program monitor, not for other monitors. If you want to make a cut using mouse, you select the razor tool, bring your playhead to the point where you want to make the cut and do the cut. But let me tell you a shortcut so that you don't need to select the razor tool again and again whenever you are making a cut. You can simply hold the control key or command key and hit the K key. It will make the cut for you. This shortcut saves a lot of time. Use it. Another bonus tip. What if you want to cut every layer at once? This shortcut is amazing. So let's say at your playhead, there are multiple layers. Video, audio, and many more, and you want to cut all of them at once, then what you can do is simply hold the shift control key on your Windows and shift command key on your Mac and hit the K key. It will do your job. So easy. If you want to move left or right of the clip, you simply click the left or right arrow key on your keyboard, right? It will take you one frame to the left and one frame to the right. But it's kind of slow. What if you want to move a little fast? Then in that case, what you can do is you simply hold the shift key on your keyboard and then hit the left and right arrow keys. What it will do is it will take you 5 frames to the left and 5 frames to the right at a time. It comes in very handy, I'll tell you. Let's say you're going through a clip and you don't want to start it from where it is starting right now. You want to start it from a particular location. Then what do? You bring your playhead to that location, then select the razor tool, cut all the layers, then using selection tool, select all the layers and hit delete. But your job is not done yet because there is a space created between other clips because of that deletion. Then what do? You select that blank space and hit the delete key. Right? It's a lot of work. What if I tell you that you can do all of that using one keystroke? Yes. So what you need to do is, if you want to delete the left portion of the clip, all the layers, then hit the Q key. And if you want to delete the right portion of the clip, then hit the W key. It's the magic trick. It happens quite often while editing that you don't want the clip to be here and you want this to be moved to some other location on the timeline. Let's say you don't want this clip to be here and you want it to be moved at this point. Then what do? You drag and drop it here, but what it does is it overrides the previous clip and that's not what you want. So then what do? You move this clip on the upper layer, select the other clips that you want to be moved, and then fit this particular clip at your desired location. It's such a waste of time. Don't do it. Stop it if you're doing it. What you need to do is simply hold the command key if you're on Mac or control key if you're on Windows. Then hold the clip and drop it wherever you want. It will adjust the whole timeline accordingly without affecting other clips. It's so simple, right? If you want to make a copy of the clip, or I say duplicate the clip, then what do? I am not talking about commands here, command V here, because that doesn't work that efficiently on the timeline. I'll tell you a different shortcut to do that. What you can do is simply hold the Alt key on your keyboard, select your clip and move it one layer above. It simply makes the copy of your clip. So simple, right? Let's say you want to apply a video transition between two clips. Then what do you do for that? You go to effects panel, search for the transition, drag and drop it between the clips, correct? But to shorten this whole process, what you can do is, whatever transitions you use most of the time for audio and for video, make them your default transition. You can do it like this. In my case, I use two transitions most of the time, dip to black and cross dissolve. Let me make one of them my default transition. Similarly, you can do that for audio. Now, what you need to do is select the clips and press Command and D on Mac or Control and D on Windows. This will apply that default video transition to your clips. Similarly, if we select the audio file and press Command Shift D on Mac or Control Shift D on Windows, it will apply the default audio transition. It applies the transition to the front and back of the clips too, but you can delete it if you don't need it there. If you're working on a big timeline and you want to move all the clips from a playhead position either to the left or to the right, then how do you do it? You need to shrink the timeline first, then select the clips like this and move it to the right. But it's very likely that you'll miss something because you can't see it properly and you don't know whether you picked everything from the right of the playhead or not. So an easy way to do this is first expand the timeline, then hit A to select everything from the right of the playhead. Now you see this double array cursor. Just click here it will select everything from the right, and then you can simply move it. Similarly, if you want to select everything from the left, then hit Shift with A and it'll do the same thing for you. That's it for this video, guys. If this video was helpful for you, give a big thumbs up. And also, if you like video editing tutorials like this one, then make sure to subscribe to our channel and also hit the notification bell so that you will be notified for our next video. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.